My name is Mark Pietrick and I'm the 1-2 teacher at St Anthony's Primary School. This year we've been participating in a research project exploring the potential of using challenging maths tasks. St Anthony's has been working in partnership with the Monash research team now for a couple of years. Today we're going to be doing a lesson about measurement and volume. So the students will be using cubes to look at different ways of making prisms. The purpose of the lesson being to see that the same number of cubes can be used to make different prisms, with a big idea being that the same volume can look different. In the early years, it's important to help the students develop their mathematical vocabulary as they create, describe and build prisms using cubes. We pose the problems to the students and then get them to explore with their thinking and their strategies before they actually then work and share those ideas with other students and also with the teacher as well for scaffolding. What's special about the way we're structuring the lesson today is that the students are launched directly into the task prior to any instruction and they're giving it a go themselves first. Enabling prompts are then given for those students who are maybe stuck in that zone of confusion, and then extending prompts as well for those students who are finding the task a little bit easier. What I really like about this sequence is that the tasks are challenging and that it also provides the opportunity for the students to actually go beyond their level, the grade 1-2 level. It also enables them to make the connections for themselves, persist and also see themselves as mathematicians.
We like making rectangular prisms with 12 cubes. I tried different solutions to see if they work. I like maths because it's challenging.
I like learning maths because it's easy, because the answers always make sense and it's never really hard to understand when you find out the answer.
If you're not used to this technique, it can feel like a little bit of a disaster, especially if you haven't done it before. It can feel like you've lost a little bit of control as teacher as you step back, but it does really work. The kids love it, they enjoy the challenge of the tasks, and them actually then making those connections themselves is really important. It is a shift in pedagogy for a lot of teachers. The most important thing is to actually give it a go, because it can seem daunting at the start. Once you do go through the sequences and see what the kids do and the thinking and the language it really develops, I think that's when you really start to see the benefit of this type of learning and where it can take the kids with their maths.